All right, so welcome everybody. Today I have Darlene from Wapaskwa Virtual Collegiate. Did I get that right, Darlene, for pronunciation?
Yes, you did.
Awesome. I was practicing that one. And so I have a few questions for Darlene with regards to Wapaskwa Virtual Collegiate. And the first question is, who is Wapaskwa Virtual Collegiate for?
Good morning, everyone. Miigwech, kaya numa. Wapaskwa is for students that are affiliated with MFNERC schools. We have member schools that most of Manitoba belongs to. And these First Nations can log into Wapaskwa and have the experience of learning online.
So it's a virtual collegiate, so everything is online, I take it, correct?
Everything is online. All the courses are online.
Now, if I'm a high school student and I'm on a reserve school, or actually I'm not in the school building, or I'm in the school building and I want to take a course from Wapaskwa Virtual Collegiate, are there any admission requirements I need to be aware of?
Not really. It is very much like a normal, regular high school. But aside from that, you need the technology and the bandwidth, being able to log in, and by bandwidth, I mean you need the accessibility to enough to support your courses and your school. Sometimes if you don't have enough bandwidth, you can run into some issues or problems, but there are ways to work around that.
So definitely if you have internet access, it should be a strong internet connection.
Not necessarily strong, because you can also use your phone.
Oh,
You don't actually need a huge setup. You can actually use your telephone, cell phones.
So would you need to be in a high school building to access some of the virtual courses that you offer at Wapaskwa Virtual Collegiate?
No, you can access it from anywhere. You don't have to be in school. Many students work from home. They learn from home, and then of course, many of our communities have overcrowded homes, but we would recommend that you find a place where you can do your learning and submitting your assignments and everything. Other than that, the schools are available, and because of COVID, it has had a huge impact on how the schools operate right now, because you can't open the schools, or for some reason they're closed because of construction, whatever. But it's usually doable to catch up if you're behind, or the instructors are more than willing to accommodate the students.
So at Wapaskwa Virtual Collegiate, what courses are offered online?
Offer 39 courses, and some of them include accounting, applied family studies, communication, information technology, biology, chemistry, history, physics, and sciences, global issues, Ojibwe, and phys ed, health ed, and pre-calculus, print communications. Yeah, those are some of the courses we offer. And
wow.
Then we also...
Oh, go ahead.
Oh, we also have some other courses that are called recovery courses, which is, I think it contains six courses right now, and they're developing more, and which is a good thing to have, because again, the COVID, people can get their credits that they missed out on.
So 39 courses to select from, that's awesome. You know what? I know you mentioned a few of them and provided a great overall choices of courses, a lot of variety, and that's great. So I'll provide a list of all the courses after this video. So stay tuned for that. Also, one of the courses you mentioned was family studies. Could you elaborate on family studies 40S course?
Studies, applied family studies 40S is a good course because it's preventative, proactive, and practical, intended to strengthen individuals and families. And now after you have the knowledge and whatever applied family studies entails, you can go into a 40-hour practical experience with children, where you observe their behavior, guide behavior, ensure that it's healthy and safe, and participate in on play-based learning experiences. You know how we accommodate children and how we play. And the staff are responsible for securing the required 40-hour work placement to get the credit. And you can also achieve the prerequisites and recommended requirements to get into childcare or anything to do with family care. You need your, and it'll also ensure your criminal record, vulnerability sector check, child abuse registry check, and emergency first aid CPR, and that's inclusive of infant and child CPR.
Yeah, that sounds awesome. So this course, so what I'm hearing, and correct me if I'm wrong, Darlene, but what I'm hearing is with applied family studies 40S course, after completion, I could possibly get work.
Right.
In a nursery or daycare or some kind of environment of that nature.
Child related, yes.
Awesome. And is there also possibility if I was to go to college and I want to further my studies for this credit to be applied to any post-secondary institutions like Red River College?
Yes, it can. And it could be a prerequisite for other courses that you might want to take as well.
All right. So students, keep that in mind if you are looking for work.
Yeah,
that's a great course that's offered with or through Wapaskwa Virtual Collegiate. Now, I know we talked a little bit about this already, but you know, if I was a student, can I still take classes at my school building and select courses at Wapaskwa Collegiate?
Yes, you can. And depending on what you're taking and where you're going to school and what you're interested in. And of course, we always have to think about our workload. We don't want to overwork our students, but at the same time, we want to accommodate them in terms of their needs.
Oh, it sounds like it's very flexible for students, which is nice.
Yes, it is. And then you can log in. If you missed a class, you can log in 24/7 to see what you've missed or to hand in your assignments. You can do that as well.
I know we alluded to this a little bit, but what kind of technology would I need to become a student at Wapaskwa? I know as you mentioned, a cell phone could be possible.
Yeah, you can use any electronic device, a laptop, a tablet, a home computer, pretty much any anything that you can access our school by.
Again, sounds very flexible with regards to different devices that you can use to access these online courses, which is awesome.
Right.
If I was interested in taking classes at Wapaskwa, where do I start? Like, what would be my next steps or first steps?
You can start by on the website. We have a website, and it's under a Manitoba First Nation Education Resource Center. Through there, you can see our link, and then you can register that way. You can also, we have facilitators that overlook our students in the communities as well, in the schools. You can go through the school, your school. And if not, you can call Wapaskwa through that link as well. There, we have all our information, how to get a hold of us and how to get in touch with Wapaskwa. There's all kinds of ways you can get that kind of information.
So it sounds if I wanted to find out more information about Wapaskwa Virtual Collegiate, then I would access the link, possibly phone, and possibly inquire even at my own school.
Emails. Yeah.
And emails as well. Awesome. And so what we'll do is we'll provide some of that contact information in the credits after this video.
Yeah. And I wanted to touch base on another thing, and that's about language and culture.
Yeah, for sure.
Reconciliation part of Canada includes culture and language. And with Wapaskwa, many of us are either learning or looking at learning, or we already have the language. And then we also offer courses. So Annie Belanger teaches grade 9 and 10 Ojibwe. And then she's developing grade 11 Ojibwe, which is exciting. And then we have Anna McGilvery. She's a developer. She's not teaching it yet, but she's a developer for Cree, grade 10. And then Ida Bear, we have developing Cree, grade 11. It's not offered yet, but they'll be offered in probably the fall, I would say.
So it sounds like Wapaskwa Virtual Collegiate has courses that are still evolving and being added as well to the current
three. Yes, it's still courses. It's growing. Yeah.
So I encourage students to check out the links that we're going to provide after this video and really explore your options. Explore. There's lots of options out there, and Wapaskwa Virtual Collegiate could be an option for you.
Yes.
I want to say thank you, Darlene, for participating in this video. And those who are watching, stay tuned for more videos to come.